Hello. How should the board take part in strategic planning? It's a fascinating question that we encounter quite often. That's what I will talk about in this video. The board answers to the shareholders that the company implements a strategy that grows shareholder value. Shareholder value grows best when the company creates a sustainable competitive advantage with its strategy. What makes us unique and excellent? How does it create value for customers? How is uniqueness reflected in products, the operating model, the knowledge base, or ability to scale? Are we different enough from our competitors? The board's role in strategic planning varies from company to company. A minimum requirement is that the board accepts the management strategy once a year. This is, however, not the best model. It would be worth for the board to put in more effort. The board's experience and knowledge base must be fully utilized when strategic options are weighed. When the board considers strategic thinking and leadership to be its most important task, better results are achieved. This is important when the business environment is changing rapidly. The best results are achieved when the board takes part in strategic planning at three stages. These stages are 1. Recognizing challenges and opportunities. 2. Evaluating strategic options. 3. Strategic choices and focus. In these three phases, the role of the board is crucial. At the start of the strategic planning process, the board needs to define challenges. What critical questions, challenges, and opportunities need to be answered? Do the big questions relate to, for example, competition, growth, stagnation, technological disruption, or a too heavy cost structure? Towards the midway point in the strategic planning process, the CEO must present the board strategic choices. The board gives feedback on the options and recognizes the most critical questions that still need to be considered. Towards the end of the strategic planning process, the CEO presents the strategy proposal to the board. The options and choices have been carefully considered and they are well justified. The company has the ability and resources to proceed on the chosen path. It is easy now for the board to give their approval. In this process, the board has from the very beginning challenged and sparked the thinking. Management and staff have listened to the board's advice. The CEO leads the process and asks for advice and sparring from the board. It's important that the CEO asks the board for sparring timely. Then the board notices how strategic thinking and the level of understanding have improved over time, moment by moment. The board has an easier time deciding on the chosen strategy. When the CEO can lean on solid support from the board, the ingredients for success exist. Thinking about the strategy is the board's most important task. Questions are asked like, where are we going? Where will we invest? And how do we increase company valuation? The CEO is the company's number one strategist. With the CEO's leadership, the company creates a winning strategy and ensures its implementation. The board is a valuable discussion partner for the management, bringing valuable experience from outside the company. The board needs to keep a close eye on the windshield. The board should think about the future 80% of the time. The strategic cooperation between the board and the CEO determines the company's success. This is especially important if the company's financial performance slips or the business environment is unpredictable. The strategic expertise of the board and the CEO is reflected in the company's numbers and valuation factor with a slight delay. Would you like to talk about the board's involvement in the strategic planning? Please get in touch. Let's ignite strategy. Take care.